Hi there. This analogy will explain how Romberg's test works to check for proprioceptive or vestibular incoordination. Incoordination is also known as ataxia. Before looking at Romberg's test, we will touch on the main three sensory systems that help maintain body posture. These are vision, proprioception, and the vestibular system. These three sensory systems are represented by the three supporting green blocks. For analogy purposes, it does not matter which green block represents which sensory system. They all send sensory information to the cerebellum. This is shown by the heavy golden bell. The cerebellum, alongside other brain structures, influences our skeletal muscles. This helps to keep us upright. This is represented by the grey plank. To perform Romberg's test, ask the person to stand unsupported with both feet together. The hand should be by their side with their eyes open. Check for any sway. Stand close by in case they fall. Then ask them to close their eyes. The main thing is to compare the swaying with eyes open versus eyes closed. Romberg's is positive when there is a significant change in balance from eyes open to eyes closed. In a normal person with eyes open, there should be no movement. With eyes closed, there may be a slight sway, but it should not fall. The difference in movement between eyes open and closed is minimal. This would be a negative Romberg's test. This is represented by one of the supporting green blocks representing vision being removed due to closed eyes. This causes a slight swaying of the grey plank. The other two green blocks and the bell are unaffected. Incoordination due to a proprioceptive issue is called sensory ataxia. Damage to peripheral nerves or the dorsal column will impair proprioception. This means joint position sense information cannot reach the cerebellum. With eyes open, there may be a slight sway. This is seen by one of the supporting green blocks representing proprioception being removed. This may cause a slight swaying of the grey plank. The other two green supporting blocks and the bell are unaffected. There is no significant sway or falling. This is because the visual and vestibular systems compensate for the proprioceptive loss. With eyes closed, now the only working sensory system is the vestibular system. This cannot compensate for the proprioceptive loss and now visual information loss. This means the patient may sway significantly or even fall. This is seen by another supporting green block, this time representing vision being removed due to closed eyes. This makes the plank very unstable, causing it to fall. The remaining vestibular green supporting block and the bell are unaffected. Swaying or falling in sensory ataxia can occur in any direction. With permanent proprioceptive damage, Romberg's test would always be positive. This is because the brain cannot compensate for proprioceptive loss over time. Incoordination due to a vestibular lesion is called vestibular ataxia. Acute vestibular damage impairs spatial orientation. This means this information cannot reach the cerebellum. With eyes open, there may be a slight sway. This is seen by one of the supporting green blocks representing the vestibular system being removed. This causes a slight swaying of the grey plank. The other two supporting green blocks and the bell are unaffected. There is no significant sway or falling. This is because vision and proprioception compensate for the vestibular loss. With eyes closed, now the only working sensory system is proprioception. This cannot compensate for the vestibular loss and now visual information loss. This means the patient may sway significantly or even fall. This is seen by another supporting green block, this time representing vision being removed due to closed eyes. This makes the plank very unstable, causing it to fall. The remaining proprioception green block and the bell are unaffected. Swaying or falling tends to occur towards the side of the lesion. If the vestibular damage becomes chronic, these patients may have a negative Romberg's. This is because over time, the brain can compensate for the vestibular loss. This is not shown in the analogy. In both sensory and acute vestibular ataxia, Romberg's test is positive. Interestingly, Moritz Heinrich Romberg described his test to check for sensory ataxia due to tabes dorsalis. Later on, however, it was adopted as a test for vestibular ataxia also. Incoordination due to cerebellum damage is called cerebellar ataxia. All three sensory systems work to send information to the cerebellum, but if the cerebellum is damaged, it cannot compute this information to maintain posture. This means that even with eyes open, there is already marked swaying. This is shown by the heavy golden bell being removed. The bell being removed means it cannot act as a counterweight. This makes the grey plank unstable even though all three supporting green blocks are in place. The direction of swaying or falling depends on which part of the cerebellum is affected. Patients with cerebellar vermis damage may sway in any direction. Patients with cerebellar hemisphere damage tend to sway towards the affected side. With eyes closed, the swaying may slightly increase to the point of falling. This is seen by one of the supporting green blocks, representing vision, being removed due to closed eyes. Despite the two remaining supporting green blocks, the grey plant becomes more unstable and falls. In cerebellar ataxia, even though swaying may increase with eyes closed, this is not a positive Romberg's. Even normal people with closed eyes may sway more. Romberg's is only positive if there is significant worsening of posture from eyes open to closed. Cerebellar patients already have abnormal balance to begin with eyes open. This may get slightly worse with eyes closed. This is why cerebellar ataxia does not cause a positive Romberg's. Incoordination that is non-organic is called functional ataxia. Sometimes patients with functional ataxia may have a falsely positive Romberg's. They can stand with eyes open without issue, but with eyes closed, they suddenly become very unsteady. This can be difficult sometimes to differentiate from a truly positive Romberg's. Thankfully, three useful tips may help with this. Firstly, with closed eyes, functional patients sway or gyrate from their hips rather than their ankles. This is shown by the person moving from their hips rather than their feet. Also, despite the significant swaying, they are unlikely to fall so that they do not hurt themselves. This is seen by the grey plank being very unstable but does not fall. Secondly, check if there's any change with distraction. This is done by asking them to touch their alternating hands, outstretched finger, to their nose back and forth. When done with eyes open, this is fine. With eyes closed, they will become distracted from the task. This distraction will help to maintain a normal posture. This is shown by the person maintaining their posture with eyes open and eyes closed whilst touching their nose with alternating hands. The grey plank is not moving during the task. Thirdly, their neurological sensory and vestibular exam would be normal. In summary, body posture relies on intact visual, proprioceptive, and vestibular information going to the cerebellum. Damage to proprioception or vestibular sense makes patients rely heavily on their vision. This can be temporarily lost with eyes closed, causing significant unsteadiness or even falling. Because of this, Romberg's test is positive in sensory and vestibular ataxia. The key with Romberg's test is assessing balance first with eyes open, then seeing how much it changes with eyes closed. In sensory or vestibular ataxia, there is little to no sway with eyes open. Closing eyes causes marked swaying or falling. This is a significant change from eyes open to eyes closed. This is a positive Romberg's. In cerebellar ataxia, there is already marked swaying with eyes open. Closing eyes may slightly increase this. The change from eyes open to eyes closed is not that much. This is not a positive Romberg's. Functional ataxia might mimic a positive Romberg's, but there will be several inconsistencies. These include unusual swaying, distractibility, and a normal sensory examination. Be aware that some conditions can cause a combined sensory and cerebellar ataxia. This will make the Romberg's falsely negative. Only by specifically testing proprioception can you work this out. This is one of the reasons not to do Romberg's test in isolation from the rest of the neurological examination.